The biggest problem in the library, the biggest rule that's not followed.
Gum. When it gets on, if it fell out of my mouth, I would pick it up and put it in the trash. When it falls out of a student's mouth, it stays on the carpet. I have to clean it up. This makes me very unhappy. Every once in a while, the wrinkling of cellophane, food, peanuts. Oh, and stop touching me. Quilly! People touching each other leads to problems. So we have a no touching rule.
Here at Trevor Brown High School in Phoenix, Arizona, students practice their freedom of speech, within their boundaries, of course. Unlike Trevor Brown, Charlie Hebdo newspaper is known for their crude humor and being boundless. Hebdo headquarters in Paris was attacked by three masked men claiming to be affiliated with an extremist group. Their motive? Revenge for the drawing of the Prophet Muhammad on the cover of the French newspaper. The attack resulted in 12 deaths, 10 injuries, and one unanswered question. Should the press have a limit to the freedom of speech? Trevor Brown High School responds to why they think Hebdo News published the animations on their cover.
Well, that's the point of a satirical newspaper. They include social and political cartoons that are slightly offensive, that promote critical thinking. And we can see this in our everyday life here in the United States. An example are satirical TV shows, just like The Colbert Report or The Tonight Show, that promotes critical thinking. And also gives us a chance to view a different perspective on a situation in which we are biased on.
I think that he published those images because he had some sort of bitterness or some sort of position that was contrary to those other religions. When he takes it to that extremity only to mock people behind closed doors, behind walls, in his safety zone, when only other people will see, well, I think that he's being sort of like a coward with it. He takes those images and publishes them so that other people who are probably not even of that religion he's mocking, or that position he's mocking, they won't take any offense to it. But when he takes those images and what he said to foreign places where they do hold those positions, that religion on a wide range, then I think he won't even publish and he won't even pronounce it because he's being a coward with it. I think he published them just because of some sort of bitterness, some position against them that he just wanted to make fun of and make and put people to scorn.
I believe in freedom of the press. I believe in freedom of expression, but I also believe in civility. And what civility is honoring and observing what people hold dear and what they hold special, and what, quite frankly, can move them to violence and create a difficult situation. Making fun of a government's political decisions, that's the right of the press. Making fun of popular positions taken by Republicans and Democrats, or creating political cartoons criticizing one form of government versus the other, I think that's all an acceptable form of self-expression in a free society. But with freedom comes a responsibility to do no harm, to not insult, to not offend, and to not hurt. I think when you start getting into religious beliefs, race, gender, sexual orientation, I do believe that there have to be some parameters. And when there are no parameters, I think you see the consequences of what can happen.
They also gave their thoughts on the outcome of the publication and what it brought.
Well, it all depends on what you believe in, and if you take your religion seriously. Muslims did take their religion very seriously, so it really depends on their views and beliefs. And should justice be served to those that did the bombing? I really do believe that it should, but in a sense that they did provoke them, they did send threats to the actual workplace, so it really is controversial on both sides.
There's a difference from being righteous on a point than being reasonable on that same point. So they weren't right or anywise righteous with what they did, but obviously it was reasonable, you know? So Charlie was mocking in his safety zone, supposed safety zone. So the other people took knowledge to that and offended him. How they knew how to offend him. It wasn't behind their clothes, their safety. It wasn't in their safety zone. They did it abruptly. They terrorized, you know. So I think that they were reasonable. It's not that much that they acted out of right, but out of reason, you know. While Charlie, he was unreasonable with what he did, but he did have a right to offend.
Terrorism and violence are never an option. The newspaper, quite frankly, is wrong in its judgment to attack the religious beliefs of millions of people around the world with such an offensive cartoon to practitioners of that religion. The terrorists, and they are terrorists, were equally wrong in using violence and death to prove a point. Nothing is to be gained from terrorism or violence at all in any given situation. If those terrorists were truly concerned with the offense that they believe was committed to Islam, they have channels that they can voice that frustration. There's government structures, there's activist groups, there's social media, there's blogs. There's other ways to express your disagreement than going straight to violence and killing people. I believe that was just a group of terrorists. I believe it had nothing to do with whether they were offended by the cartoonists or not. I believe it was a terrorist group. They had motive. They had planned out what they wanted to do regardless. And what they wanted, their mission was death and destruction. And that's what they did, and that's what they achieved. They made no political statement. They certainly can't convince me or any other of the millions of other peace-loving citizens in the United States or around the world that was based off of any sort of a political motive. It was terrorism, it was violence, and that's all that it was.
Is there a limit? Should the press have barriers? Limitations to the freedom of speech? Should we all? I'm Andres Aguilar, BTV News.
Hey, Omar, what do you think about the cheese?
I gotta say, I have to warn some of the people who want to eat the cheese off this list. They're a little bit strong on taste, as if they're not. The aftertaste isn't that good.
The aftertaste isn't that good.
Yeah, but hey, on the inside, as soon as you taste it, it's heavy.
What's your favorite cheese?
Well, I gotta say, it's so far this one.
What's that one called?
It's this one.
What is that called?
The chèvre.
Chèvre.
Chèvre. Chèvre.
And my second favorite is the camembert.
Camin?
Yep.
What is that? Oh, camembert.
Yep. All right.
Which is that one?
Huh?
Is it in here? Or did you eat it?
Yeah. My other ones I picked out are elemental, brie, and this one.
All right. What is that? Gruyere?
Yeah.
Say that.
Gruyere.
Gruyere. All right, man.
Yep. Well, anyway, after I tasted the cheese, I have to say, by far, brie is actually my favorite so far. Well, I best be on my way home. So, au revoir, BTV.
Mr. Sosa, what is your favorite cheese?
My favorite cheese would have to be the Camembert. It's a brown cheese made in Normandy, exclusively in Normandy, and it has a white rind. On some bread, it's good, or I like to put it in the oven so it melts. It becomes sort of like a fondue, and I dip my bread in there, my vegetables in there. It's really good too. I feel like something a little bit sweeter, creamier, like maybe some fruits and nuts, and I would say that blue is the least popular.
Blue was the least popular? Yep. I didn't like it at all.
It's very strong, it's pungent, that's because it's aged for a little bit longer, and the maltier the cheese, probably the stronger it's going to be.
That's unappealing, but I'll try it.
Not so clever.
That's really good. I like this one.
Which one? Yeah.
Which one?
The second. I like it.
That blue is definitely
blue.
Hey, Tristan.
Either hate it or love it. Let's see what happens.
Do you like the harder cheeses? Yeah.
Okay, next is Ponte. Okay. Gruyere. Gruyere. See how they said.
What are you talking about?
What are you talking about?
Hey, hang on. But you know, actually,
don't
get that.
It's not bad. It tastes like nothing. And mental. This is called mental. Not elementary. Mental.
And mental.
Mental is great. I like mental. I like mental. This is a mental. It's not good, but you want more. That's the thing about this one.
Okay, that's it.
3 hours. Alright. I think I covered all the cheeses, so I'm gonna get more of this one. I like it.
Merci. Merci. Merci.
Merci.
Merci. Merci, à bientôt.
I had a great experience trying all these French cheeses with Mr. Sosa and Omar and the rest of the gang. I would say that if you really like cheese, get on out there and try some Parisian culture. You'll find some that you like, don't like, some that are really strong for your taste buds. But all in all, just try it. Au revoir.
whatever we break them, nothing's gonna stop us now. Let's get down to it. Nervous hands and anxious smiles, I can feel you breathing. This is right where we belong.